Dear students, now I am going to discuss on rat skin structure. Skin is also called as integument. So, skin of rat, if you take its cross section and observe it in the microscope, it shows different structures. Mainly it is made up of two layers, epidermis, dermis. Epidermis is outermost layer, below that dermis is present. Dermis is 2 to 3 times thicker than epidermis. So epidermis is the outermost layer. Epidermis is derived from ectoderm. Epidermis is ectodermal derivative. And it is multilayer, and it has two layers again. Epidermis has two layers. Lower epidermal layer is called stratum germinativum, and outer layer is called as stratum cornea. So lower layer, stratum germinativum, produces new cells. These cells go on dividing and redividing, and they add cells to upper epidermal layer. So upper epidermal cells become flattened and their cytoplasm is replaced by the keratin protein, insoluble keratin protein. Therefore, the outermost layers of epidermis is cornified layer. It has dead cells, and this layer breaks at certain places, and these cells may shut, may fall off. So let's about the lower layer, outer layer, stratum corneum. I told you, composed of dead cells, cornified cells, and these cells do not have any cytoplasm. That cytoplasm is replaced by keratin protein. So next part is dermis. Dermis is mesodermal in origin. It's a mesodermal derivative. Okay, dermis is made up of mainly areolar connective tissue. Areolar connective tissue. You know, areolar connective tissue has spaces in between the components of connective tissue. So, connective tissue has blood vessels, lymph vessels, nerves, nerve fibers, muscle fibers, all these are there in the areolar connective tissue. So, to the epidermal layer, the nutrients are supplied from dermis, because dermis is supplied with blood vessels. Next, below the dermis, fat layer is present. Because of the presence of fat layer, the skin is bit spongy, and fat layer acting as insulating layer. It prevents loss of heat from the body, because you know the rat belongs to class mammalia. Mammalians are homeothermic. They try to maintain their body temperature. They regulate their body temperature. So for that sake, that fat is being used. Next up, the dermis is also having other structures like hair root, sweat glands, oil glands. Hairs can be seen outside the epidermis, but their roots are present in the dermis. Sweat glands are there, sweat glands secrete sweat. Oil glands are there, oil glands are also called as sebaceous glands. They produce oil. That oil lubricates hair. So all these structures develop from the cells of stratum germinativum is the lower layer of epidermis. Here, continuously dividing. These divided cells move from inner layer, lower layer of stratum or germinatum into dermis. There they become either root hair, sweat glands or pile glands. So this is about the structure of integument, skin in the rash, in brief. Now coming to talk about skin derivatives in the rat. Hair. See, all mammals' body surface is covered by hair. Hair is a fine cylindrical cornified filament, and it has two parts. Outer part is called shaft, inner part is called root. Outer part is shaft, inner part is root. And this root is covered in the dermis layer of skin. Okay, the different structures derived from skin are sweat glands. Sweat glands are also derived from skin. Sweat glands are also called as sudorifices. Sudorifices, glands, and these sweat glands produce sweat. So sweat contains excretory substances. So sweat glands are functionally excretory, as well as they take part in lowering body temperature. Then oil or sebaceous glands. So these glands produce oily substance. This oil is secreted into the hair follicle for lubricating hair. Then lacrimal or tear glands. These glands are present in the eye orbits, and these glands produce secretions which is being used for cleaning eye surface. So lacrimal glands. Milk or mammary glands are present only in lactating mothers. So they are also modified sweat glands. They produce milk, and this milk is used for feeding young ones. Next, meibomian glands are also modified sweat glands, and they are present at the base of eyelashes, meibomian glands. And these glands produce antimicrobial secretion, which prevents the infection of eye from microorganisms. Meibomian glands. Oily secretion keeps the surface of the eye wet. So Ceruminous glands produce, they are present in the external ear meatus, means external ear. The ear canal is there. Inside the ear canal, ceruminous glands are present. They produce waxy secretion. This waxy secretion lubricates eardrum, hyperic membrane. These are the different types of glands. And one more structure is there, one more derivative of skin, claws. Claws are seen in rat. So these claws are used for digging defensive structures. So hairs are used for insulating the body surface. So this is about the structure of skin and its derivatives. Okay, let us study the body cavity present in rat. The body cavity is also called cilium. You know what is meant by cilium? Cilium is a body cavity which is internally lined by mesodermal epithelium. So here in rat, body cavity is present in the trunk region. Trunk has been divided into two parts, such as thoracic cavity and abdominal cavity. Between these two, the circular muscular partition is there, that is called diaphragm. So interior, like this. This is thoracic cavity. And this is abdominal cavity.
So dental formula of
RAD is 1003 by 1003 into 2 equals to 16. So each half of the jaw has 4 teeth. Each jaw has total 8 teeth. 8 plus 8, 16. 1 plus 3, 4. 1 plus 3, 4. So 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 8, 16. So totally 16 teeth are present in that. So incisors, each half of the jaw has one incisor, 3 molars. 3 molars. So canines and premolars are absent. Canines and premolars are absent in RAD. So this is the dental formula of RAD. 1003 by 1003 into 2 equals to 16. So totally 16 teeth are there. Therefore, that type of arrangement of teeth, different types of teeth is called heterodont type of dentition. Then monophiodont. Only one set of teeth is there in RAD. Only one set of teeth. In case of human beings, two sets. One is milk set and another is permanent set. Therefore, in human beings, the dentition is referred as diphiodont. Whereas here in RAD, monophiodont. Okay, so that's about this. Next part of the elementary canal is pharynx. Pharynx comes after buccal cavity. And this pharynx is again has two parts. Pharynx has two parts. Nasopharynx and oropharynx. Nasopharynx and oropharynx. Nasopharynx is connected to nasal chambers. Nasal chambers are connected to pharynx to this nasopharyngeal region. Then oropharynx receives opening of buccal cavity. Buccal cavity opens directly behind into oropharynx. From oropharynx, food enters into esophagus. So esophagus is present on dorsal surface of the windpipe. So from oropharynx, esophagus. So this is esophagus. Esophagus is a tubular structure that starts from pharynx up to the stomach. It passes through thoracic cavity, neck, thoracic region, passing through the diaphragm. It has the abdominal cavity and this is the abdomen. It connects pharynx to the stomach. So this is stomach. Stomach is a wide, sac-like structure where food is stored for some time. This is stomach. Stomach has two parts. This is cardiac stomach, pyloric stomach. So integrated this is fundus. This stomach has two curvatures. This is anterior curvature is concave, posterior curvature is convex. This is lesser curvature, this is greater curvature. So this is stomach. So from stomach, the small intestine arises, it develops. The small intestine is divided into three parts, duodenum, jejunum and ileum. The length of the small intestine in that is 1 to 1.2 meter. So first part of the small intestine is duodenum. So duodenum is the first part of the small intestine which receives secretion of liver. Liver secretes bile. The bile is poured, added to this elementary canal at this region, at this level, through bile duct. Small intestine, okay? It is quiet. Duodenum, middle part is jejunum, and the last part is ileum. Ileum is connected to large intestine. So large intestine is again divided into three parts: cecum, colon, rectum. So cecum is sac-like structure. It is ended in the vermiform appendix. This is cecum. Okay, from the cecum, colon arises. Colon has three limbs: ascending limb or ascending colon, transverse colon, and descending colon. Descending colon. Ascending, transverse, descending colon. And this colon opens into rectum. The last part of the large intestine is rectum. Okay, rectum opens to the exterior through anus. Anus is guarded by anal sphincter. Anal sphincter. When undigested material is ready for dissection, this sphincter relaxes through the anus. Undigested material is dissected out. So that's about the structure of the alimentary canal. Alimentary canal. Okay. Now the digestive glands. Let us talk about digestive glands associated with alimentary canal. Alimentary canal. So there are different types of digestive glands.
This has no gallbladder. Rat has no gallbladder.
no, you know, storage of bile takes place in the gland. Directly it comes to duodenum. This bile helps in digestion of fat. So that's about liver. So next, digestive gland is pancreas. So this is pancreas. Pancreas is a diffused gland present in the space form, you know, in between heart and stomach and the small intestine, loop of small intestine. It's a diffused gland. And pancreas is a, you know it very well, the heterocrine gland. It is made up of exocrine part as well as endocrine part. So the exocrine part is important as far as digestion of food is concerned. So pancreas produces different enzymes. Enzymes which help in the digestion of food, such as proteolytic enzymes, lipases are there. So pancreas, the endocrine part of the pancreas produce insulin hormone. You know, insulin hormone regulates sugar level. So pancreatic enzymes are very much essential for the complete digestion of food particle, pancreas. So next digestive gland is stomach. Gastric gland. Gastric glands are present in the wall of stomach. So their secretion is called as gastric juice. So gastric juice contains HCl and pepsinogen. HCl and pepsinogen. So HCl helps in killing bacteria. It also helps in dissolving food material. Then pepsinogen. Pepsinogen is an inactive form of enzyme. Pepsinogen is converted into pepsin in presence of HCl. This pepsin is important for the digestion of protein. So that's about gastric glands. Next. Last one, intestinal glands. So intestinal glands are present in the wall of intestine. Their secretion is called intestinal juice or sucus entricus. Okay, the intestinal glands produce maltase, sucrase, lipase. They help in digestion of different types of food material. So these are the different types of digestive glands which help the process of digestion in rat. So this is about the digestive system of rat.